Suppose user enter an integer say a is equal to say 274, then want to display the output the reverse of the given number, that is 472. Okay. Now to reverse the given integer, we are going to apply here while say while a is not equal to zero, while a is not equal to zero, then okay, we are going to find the remainder by using the a is equal to a modulo 10, that is we separate the first this digit, okay, then 7, then 2 and so on, and then we put we find the value of reverse is equal to reverse into 10 plus r, okay, and then finally we replace a is equal to a by 10. So here a by 10, suppose here a is equal to 274, say 274, then r is equal to a modulo 4, that is 274 modulo 10 is equal to what, 4, and then say initially we assume here the reverse is equal to 0, so the reverse is equal to 0 plus r, that is 4, which is equal to 4, okay, and then a is equal to a divided by 10. Now since a is an integer, so it is equal to 274 divided by 10 is 27.4, but since it is an integer, it is equal to 27. Again a is not equal to 0, so again this condition is true, that is a is not equal to 0, so it enter in while loop. So next now for the second step, the value of reverse is equal to 4, then a is equal to 27. Okay, now next we want to determine the value of r. R is equal to a modulo 10, so a modulo 10, that is 27 modulo 10 is equal to 7, and a is reverse is equal to reverse, so current reverse value is 4 into 10 plus 7, so this is equal to 40 plus 7 is equal to 47, and a is equal to a divided by 10, so that is 27 divided by 10 is equal to 2.7, but since it again a is an integer, so it is equal to only 2. So for third step, again a is not equal to 0, so a is not equal to 0, so this condition is true, okay, so this condition is true, and therefore for third step our a is equal to 2, reverse, the value of reverse is 47. Okay, now next we want to determine the value of remainder. It is a, that is 2 modulo 10, which is equal to 2, that is when we divide 2 by 10 the remainder is 2, and the value of reverse is equal to current value of reverse is 47 into 10 plus 2, so it is 470 plus 2 is equal to 472, and a is equal to a divided by 10, that is 2 divided by 10, that is 0.2, but again 0, a is an integer, so the a is equal to 0.2 implies a is equal to 0, so this condition is now false, and you can check here the what is the value of reverse. Finally we are going to print the value of reverse here after when this value is false, means what, if when it come outside from the while loop, we are going to print the value of reverse. So the what is the value of reverse, it is equal to 472. So we enter here, we enter the value of 274 and we get output as 474. Okay, so now we are going to code this in C program again. Include this standard library, standard input output library, then main function, then integer, we are going to take your number from user, then we require reverse is equal to 0, and okay, reverse is equal to 0. So clear the previous output, then printf, enter your number, scanf percent d and a. Next, now we are going to while a is not equal to 0, a is not equal to 0, then okay, find the value of a is equal to a modulo 10, remainder, we want to determine remainder, so r is equal to, so here we are going to declare one variable, say remainder or r is equal to, okay, so r is equal to a modulo 10, the value of reverse is equal to the reverse into 10 plus r remainder, okay, and then we are going to reduce a is equal to a divided by 10, okay, and then finally we are going to print the value of printf, the reverse number is equal to percent d, okay, percent d, and reverse. Okay. So now if we get ch, to compile this, there is one error, clr scr. So now if you compile, zero error, and if you run this code, if you enter say 234, then output is what, 432. If we enter say again, if we run here say 1 2 3 4, then output is what, 4321. Again if we run one more time, say 333, then output is what, 333. So now we are going to take one more output, say 3456, the output is what, 6543. Now we are going to check whether given number is palindrome or not. So when we say that the given number is palindrome, if your reverse is equal to, say if the reverse number is same as the original number A, original number, then we can say that the given number is palindrome, okay. So again by using the same logic, first we are going to determine the reverse, and we then we are going to compare whether reverse is equal to A, but since here we are going to change the value of A, so initially we are going to store the value of A in other variable, okay, so say alt enter, we are going to store the value of A here, so declare one more variable, say original, okay, original variable, say is equal to original is equal to say A, and then we are going to check whether A is equal to here now if reverse is equal to original number, then equal to, this is assignment operator, we require equality operator, reverse is equal to original, then printf, it is a palindrome number, okay, else it is not, given number is not a palindrome number, printf not palindrome, not palindrome, bracket completed. Now if we compile, no error. Now if we run, if we enter say 121, now it is palindrome. What is the reverse of the 121? It is again a 121, so it is a palindrome number. If we enter say 234, then it is what? It is not palindrome number. Again, if we take one more output, say 1001, okay, it is a palindrome number, 1001. Again, in one more time, say 454, it is palindrome. So if we take one more output, say 765, it is not a palindrome number. So thank you.